This is the Match Game 74, production number 0144, air date to be announced, VT Yard 11974, and it's take one. Get ready to match the stars. Orson B. Brett Somers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Meredith MacRae. Richard Dawson. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74.
I guess I ought to have a microphone before I say, how do you do? Nice to have you with us. How is everybody over here?
We're wonderful.
Yeah, you look great.
Just fair.
No, you're not just fair.
Bless you. Can I have the rest of your three musketeers?
Don't know. Oh, yeah. Are you eating on this show?
She ate one of my three musketeers. It was wonderful.
I think they're all ready. Their blood sugar is up and all that. So yes. Let's say hello to our two players here, Virginia Shook and Julie Roach. Hello, ladies. This lady has won a lot of money, hasn't she, John? $5,600.
Wow.
And she's being challenged by Virginia, and we finished round one, and we're going to start round two in a moment or so. Are you ready for that? Okay. Round two coming up, folks. But first, we've got this message for you, and here it is. Here we go. All right, ladies, if you're ready, I'll push this button and reveal our second and final round and ask Virginia Shook, our challenger, to make a selection.
I'll try B again, please.
B. Her daughters keep advising her to try B, and that's what she's going for, and this is it. The Chinese mustard Albert ate was so hot. Would you like to know how hot it was? How hot? I'm glad you asked. It made his blank curl.
I had my hearing aid turned out. Could you do that one more time, sweetheart?
The Chinese mustard Albert ate was so hot it made his blank curl.
Oh, I get that.
Yes, sir. Something I can do for you, sir. Have you finished writing your answer?
I have. Anyone ever told you you have very lovely hands?
Yeah. Are you finished up there?
Yes.
They're finished down here. So, Virginia, we call on you for a response. The Chinese mustard Albert ate was so hot, it made his...
Can't remember what it's called, but hair.
Hair?
Yeah.
You mean the hair back
well,
here?
Well, you know, they got the long thing, but I'll say hair.
Oh.
The whole head.
Hair.
You know, the hair on your head.
Made his hair curl. I thought she was pointing the nape of her neck or something like that. Orson, she says hair, what do you say?
I said it made his doo-doo curl. It doesn't fit, but I wanted to work it in first in the show. No, I said hair.
Hair is a match. Okay, Brett, what do you say?
I say Orson Bean should leave the building. No, I said...
What did I say?
Oh, yes, it's all right. I said hair.
Here's another match for you, Virginia. All right, Charles.
I was going to say hair curl, but it's a very sensitive subject because mine can't anymore, but my toes can still do it.
Toes. Okay, what curled, Meredith?
The last time I had hot mustard, I commit my tongue to
made
uncurl.
Your tongue so curl. It'll do that. Yes, indeed. Okay.
That's reading mustard trick. Again. Would you give
I must
me a call?
Richard, take a shot
from
my
lovely time.
Terrific.
Thank you.
Get your hands off
just
that
my,
fat
my hair curl.
Hair curl. David Kiss made his hair curl.
Yeah.
You're doing very well with that, Virginia. What do you say, Marcia?
What do I say?
Yeah, what do you say?
Hair.
Hair. Okay. So that's four for you. Now let's see. You've got to match three celebrities to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Four, however, will win the game. Here we go. Last time you matched Meredith.
No.
Yes.
so right, you were, last time, right?
Last time, see?
I thought it was my tongue, yeah. But no, you're right.
I'll run the show. Okay?
Meredith, you're not in production yet.
Right. I was the only one that got it right yesterday.
Shall we push forward?
Shall we do that? Here it is.
Moving along.
Bob lost one of his contact lenses down Ellen's blank. Bob lost one of his contact lenses. Julie is thinking about that one. All right. Everybody ready? Here we go, Julie. We need an answer from you. Bob lost one of his contact lenses down Ellen's...
Bra.
What? Speak up.
Bra.
She said bra. Her answer is bra. Now, we'll find out what your answer is. Right now, it's show and tell time,
yes,
Orson.
Down Ellen's drain. No, I put it down her dress. That's what I meant.
No, they don't match that.
How dare you? A show of hands, people. Whether that should match. No,
no, they can't.
The people have spoken.
Brett, what do you say?
I say you are so cute in beige. It's your best color, outside of pink.
Yes.
Oh, yellow. Yellow is a very good color. It matches your skin.
I think you're in love with
that. I don't want that buzzer coming up here. Now, I mean it.
If hers matches, mine shouldn't.
Neckline.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, they say yes. Okay. You need two more to stay in the game,
well,
Julie.
Where else but the neckline of a dress could have contact lens
well,
fly?
Now, hold it here.
Contact lenses don't fly up, you know.
Hold everything. The logic over there, you see, is...
Never mind the logic over there.
Conceivably, well, you said dress, right?
Yes.
All right, it could have fallen down the back of her dress, you see. And specifically, that's the front.
Or the side.
Okay, Charles Nelson Reilly, may we have your response?
Kiss me.
Okay. One more for the tie. We go over here to Richard Dawson. What do you say?
I'm out.
You're out.
I say, what about some drinks over here? No, I meant the neckline. I said dress, but obviously that's where I meant.
No match there. Now, you must match Marcia to achieve the tie. Let's see if it happens.
The crowd's getting surly.
It's all up to you. You can.
No.
You're a trooper, Marcia. Remember that.
Blouse?
No? Okay. Virginia Shook is the winner. Congratulations. Okay. Will you, thank you. You may hold on to my arm while I say goodbye to Julie Roach, who's been a splendid contestant.
Thank you.
You have a beautiful smile, a marvelous personality, and $5,600. Good night, Julie. Don't we make a lovely couple? Well, this couple will return to you in just a moment or so, but first we've got a message. Shall we take a stroll through the garden, my dear?
I can't wait. Yes.
This lady has won her first game. She's got $100, and now she's going to have a try at over $5,000. You ready for that, Virginia?
Not yet.
We're a symphony in beige, aren't we? Okay, well, let's have a try at it anyway, shall we? We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Light blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250 if you match that one. And if you match a third one, it's $100 to you. Now, which celebrities would you like to get a little assist from here?
Richard Dawson.
Richard, what do you say? How do you fill in that light blank?
Oh, I answered an ad for light housework.
Lighthouse.
Just nod your head once and... I'm not interested in whether you're groaning or cheering, folks. Yes. I've got money. I've got hair oil. Lighthouse
is his
response. And we've been going around
response.
Together ever since.
Okay.
Meredith
MacRae, what do you say?
I think I would say light bulb.
You'd say light bulb.
Especially
okay.
Now with the energy shortage, right?
Right. One more.
Marcia,
what do you say to this?
Hello. Well, let's go for lightning.
Lightning. Lightning.
You thought Lighthouse was bad, huh? We got Ning over here.
She put a Ning on the light there. So you've got light bulb, lighthouse, and lightning. You may choose one of those as the answer or give us one of your own. Right now, we have to call for a response.
Light bulb.
Light bulb it is. Light Brigade. You thought of
what? I'm going to go Light Brigade.
Light Brigade.
Bulb.
You want to go for the bulb? Okay. We are looking for a light bulb, folks. Let's find out if it's up there. First, may we see the $100 response? Lightweight is a good answer. None of us thought of that one, did we? Okay, still looking for a light bulb. Let's find out if it's under the $250 response. Lighthouse is there, the one that Richard gave you.
Now, when Ning is under
that's
the
right,
next
and
one.
They booed you. You think it's going to be Brigade?
Ning.
If it is, I'm going to be awful mad.
All right, find out right now. Here is the $500 response. Meredith gave you that one. Very good, Meredith. Well done. Terrific. Okay.
Good luck.
Well, Virginia, you've got the $500. That means you'll now be playing for 10 times that amount or $5,000.
And a date with Gene Rayburn.
Okay, you'll take it anyway. Now, you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head. It must be exact match, and you have to choose one now.
I'm going to go for Meredith.
You going to go for Meredith?
Good.
I've been going for
this
Meredith for years, but she keeps turning me down, Meredith.
Everyone's been going for Richard all week, so I'm happy to be gone for him.
Meredith, you get ready to write, and Virginia will face me, and I will get the $5,000 question, and this is it. Write your answer to this, if you would, please. Jelly blank. Or jelly blank. I'll give you both accents.
Choice.
Meredith is finished, Virginia. We need your answer now. How do you fill in that blank? Jelly?
Roll.
Jelly roll, you say. Jelly roll is not...
Jelly roll.
You say it was either fish or roll, and you went for jelly roll.
That's because she's standing next to you, Rayburn.
Meredith, for $5,000, may we see your answer, please?
It's either fish or roll, and I went with fish.
Two good answers there. Really, ladies, they were both excellent answers.
I was trying to do my ESP with you and hoping that you get it.
You do ESP?
Well, I was trying.
You came close. You both thought of fish and roll. All right, Virginia, you've got $600. You're the champion. You're going to play another game. So let's meet another player right now. Here comes Patty Addison. You know Virginia Shook, do you? She's congratulating her. That's very sportsmanlike of you. Patty, would you tell us a little bit about Patty Addison?
Other than I'm scared to death and nervous, I'm from the Valley, and I have two small boys, Sean 5 and Ryan 2, and I'm a wreck.
You're a wreck? She doesn't look like a wreck to me. Does she look like a wreck to you?
Ah.
I think she's got it all together pretty good. Well, good luck, Patty. You know how to play our game. Let's get right to it, shall we? I'll push this button, and you as the challenger will make a selection. We ask you to do that because some contestants find some questions harder than others, and it's your choice.
I'll take A, so Virginia can trailer bullet girls.
A it is, Patty. Here it is. Everybody plays. Mm. The nurse said to the psychiatrist, "Doctor, why is the couch covered with tomato sauce?" And the psychiatrist replied, "Because my last patient thought he was a blank." Nurse said to the psychiatrist, "Did you hear that, Patty?" "Doctor, why is the couch covered with tomato sauce?" And the psychiatrist replied, "Because my last patient thought he was a..." Brett is finished.
Ready. No, Brett's not finished.
Now, Brett, now don't do that.
Oh, now, just a minute. Now, just be nice. Now,
All right, she's changing her mind, and that's her privilege.
Okay, now I'm still ready before Marcia.
Okay. All right, everybody ready over there. Patty, the nurse said to the psychiatrist and so forth, "Because my last patient thought he was a..."
Bottle of ketchup.
A what?
Bottle of ketchup. That's bad.
Because he thought he was a bottle of ketchup.
Yeah.
I don't think she's got it so together.
We're going to find out right now if she's got it together or not and see if anybody else says bottle of ketchup. What do you say, Orson?
And one of the worst things that can happen to any doctor is a leaky patient.
A hot dog.
Okay, no match there. Brett?
I tore that answer up.
Oh?
What did you put? Spaghetti-o. You know?
Spaghetti.
Thank
yeah.
you.
Tomato sauce.
You, my darling.
Okay.
I said a one a meatball.
One a meatball. Bottle of ketchup is what she's looking for. What do you say?
I at first was going to say pizza maker, but I said a tomato.
A tomato.
Oh, they like that one, huh?
You're getting close to a bottle of ketchup, but not yet. Richard?
I happen to know that the patient was a hamburger.
And Marcia.
Ditto.
Hamburger. Okay.
Bad.
So there's no match there, and we've got a question for you, Virginia. It'll come your way in a moment or so, but first, we've got this message of interest for you. Now let's finish round one and see how Virginia does with her end of this round. Everybody plays, and this is it. Here's a little poem. Count Dracula said, with a leer and a drool, I married my wife because she's a blank. Count Dracula said, with a leer and a drool, I married my wife because she's a blank.
I hate to keep asking you to repeat these things, but...
Would you like... I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, I forgot you don't have it.
I don't have my glasses.
Does that help?
Oh, I get it.
Got it?
Okay.
Okay.
Can't eat the rats.
All right. We are waiting, Marcia.
I know you are. God love you, James.
We've waited all week for you, Marcia. Okay. We're getting tired of it.
Now, Virginia.
You should be a...
Count Dracula said with a leer and a drool, I married my wife because she's a...
Ghoul.
A ghoul. All right. Ghoul is what she says, and let's see if we get any ghouls over here. There's a ghoul from Orson Bean.
Brett, before we go on, I'd like to ask Virginia if she needs a partner.
Okay, Brett.
That is the obvious answer, isn't it?
Ghoul, good answer.
I mean, anybody would have gotten it like that,
yeah.
Right? Except me, I said fool.
Fool. What is it?
Charles, you'll never marry me now, will you?
Charles.
When there's a vacancy on the floor below, would you call me in the dressing room? Vampire.
Vampire and ghoul do not match, I take it. What do you say about this?
I didn't know it was a poem either, somehow, and I said vampire.
Oh, really? Was my reading that bad?
At least I knew it was a poem.
With a leer and a drool, I married my wife because she's a blank.
Oh, all right.
Go ahead, Richard.
It rhymes with campfire, so should he ever come up with a poem with campfire? I said ghoul.
Ghoul is another match for you, Virginia. And now, Marcia.
I don't enjoy being embarrassed on national television at all.
Are you embarrassed on national television?
You're never going to guess I had trouble with this one. Texan.
Well,
nothing.
Marcia, I guess we all have to agree she's embarrassed on national television, isn't she? Now, may I just pause for a moment and ask what your logic was in that?
Absolutely none.
Okay. Okay.
Walking out and I,
I don't ever want to be attacked on this show again.
All right. Okay, so it's 2-0 in favor of our champion at the end of round one, and we go to round two and ask Patty to make a selection.
I'm taking B this time.
She wants B this time. All right, you didn't match anyone the first round, so that means everyone plays, folks.
Mercy.
So the king wouldn't lose the key to the queen's chastity belt. He tied it around his blank. All right. Lower tier is ready.
So is the upper tier.
All right, the upper tier is ready. Patty Addison. So the king wouldn't lose the key to the queen's chastity belt, he tied it around his...
body.
Around his body.
Waist body.
His waist or body, she said. Waist or body is her answer. Is that okay with the judge over there? The judge is nodding his head. Waist or body is the answer. Orson, what do you say?
Horse. No, I said neck.
Neck. So that can't match body or waist. Brett?
He had this terrific gold chain. It was fabulous. He left it to me, actually. And, of course, he put that bloody key around his neck.
Around his
terrific
neck.
Gold chain.
So
that's
so far, you got two necks here, Patty. Charles?
Okay, another neck.
Three necks. All right, Meredith.
I guess I like to go a little lower than that, Gene.
Already? Where, how far did you go?
Race.
There's one for you. We're here to stay in the running. What have you got there, Richard?
If you're ever going that way again,
let me know.
Come up and see me sometime.
Next. Okay. You've got to match Marcia to stay in the running. And Marcia?
Temporarily redeemed here. Neck.
Neck.
Oh, no, not
neck. She was looking for body. So Virginia is the winner. Congratulations. All right, no, she's calm now. Two games, see how it is. Patty, it was a real pleasure meeting you.
Thank you very much.
Lovely lady, we've got a gift for you backstage. Patty Addison, many thanks for being with us. Now we got a message for everybody out there, and then we'll come back to you. We just have a moment to thank all of these beautiful and talented people and say goodbye to you, to thank you for joining us, and hope that you're going to join us next time for Match Game 74. Bye-bye. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are the Weekender by American Tourister, designed to go everywhere by land, sea, or air, fiberglass reinforced construction, strong lightweight luggage by American Tourister, and a supply of AeroWax with acrylic and wax with the ruggedness of acrylic, the rich warm glow of wax in one great shine, AeroWax, and Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dishes, so quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection, Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next over most of these CBS stations.